All right, guys, so I was looking through my stack of books that I'm going to be showing off today, and it's predominantly all female leads, so it's going to be different. Usually I have, you know, just the stuff I collect is all male. But this is an interesting, most of the stuff came in the mail, and I got two from, it was a 50-cent sale, so I got two issues. And That's showing you how much I how many books I have. I'm only picking out two books in a 50-cent sale. But yeah, it's just these I ordered. I believe I got these through DCBS. That's where I got these through. So first up, Vampirella. Let's back this up just a tad. There we go. Yeah, I love this cover. So I was like, I'm gonna, you know, buy this. I've fallen off, I'm on and off with Vampirella. I'm missing like probably, I think they're up to issue 16 now, and I've been falling off, so I'm missing about four or five issues. So I gotta go back and get them all. I mean, they're great cover buys, of course, but yeah, I thought the story was pretty good. It's just one of them things where I don't like putting it on my pull list because there's a gazillion covers of Dynamite's Vampirella, but I love this because it's like the faster pussycat with the faster kill, and just I love this art. I mean, that's just it's an awesome cover, so definitely had to go score this one. Sorry about that. Next up, I bought this through DCBS too. I thought it was going to be a harder book to find, but yeah, you go into comic shops, there's like stacks like this big of it. But I love the character Punchline. I even spent a little bit of money trying to get the first appearance for Hella Risen 3. And yeah, I'm satisfied with it. I ended up selling a bunch of Legends of the Dark Knight comic book series, and I flipped that money and bought the two copies of actually Hella Risen 3, the cover A and cover B. And I still had money left over, so I thought I made out on the deal. But this is awesome. This is, of course, after the Joker War, which is what it says. But it's another one of my favorite characters from Scott Snyder's run, is Harper Row. She's in this pitch, in this comic with her brother Colin. And I think in 2021, Harper, she goes by, I think, Bluebird is her, you know, her hero name. But I think it's going to be awesome to put these two clashing this year. Got new blood in there, you know. It's got to be a little bit of something. And this is, I think it's going to be a decent storyline. So, yeah, if you even pick this up, I mean, I'm sure you're going to be able to find this stuff in, you know, half-off bins or dollar bins. Anything like that. Just, yeah, I wouldn't spend $5 on it. But I'm a huge fan, and I like that cover. So I ordered it on there. Yeah, if you haven't been reading the new Batman series, or the new Batman, it's new to me, damn it. the new Batman run with James Tyvon. It started at Batman, I think, believe issue 85. You should definitely try to at least find the trade paperbacks for that. But it's been really good, so. A couple new characters thrown in there, a couple old characters, made Harley Quinn even, readable, which I have, like, her new 52 stuff, I have the Rebirth stuff. I mean, Harley Quinn's basically been unreadable for a couple years, so, not that the art hasn't been great and stuff in some of those books, but it's just, it's actually making her a decent character in the Batman universe, so definitely check it out if you're a Harley Quinn fan. Next up, all I gotta say is we'll go a little bit. This one's pretty cool. This is La Diabla. I'm sure the Spanish speaking folks that might be watching this might be getting a good laugh at my pronunciation, but you know, I did the best I could. but this is really awesome. And all I gotta say is there's a lot of books that just aren't for me out there. I'm not saying they suck or anything like that. I mean, you know, everybody has their own opinion and stuff like that. But I'm just saying, thank you, Lord, for Eric Powell. I mean, he always comes out with great artwork, great stories, a lot of horror stuff, but I'll show you inside this a little bit. I mean, this is... this is a lead up to, I guess, a graphic novel that either came out or is coming out. I'm not 100% sure. I never followed up with it, but it's about this lady, the Diabla. And there's a quick summary is there's these four guys driving in a truck down some road in Mexico, and they have this girl kidnapped, and they're all talking about this lady because she's like some sort of demon, and or like you know, coming, they're afraid of her, or they're driving, and they all think it's either, you know, it's a bunch of there's a bunch of stories that tell how that she became La Diabla. I should have paid attention, like, you know, with the Spanish speaking part. But yeah, it just shows four different points of view, these four guys right here, and they all tell the different stories of how this lady became this this hero, we'll call her. But yeah, I just look at this artwork in here, man. It's just like, there's the part I wanted to show you guys, man. Look at that, man. That's freaking sick. So you guys gotta pick this up if you haven't. I'm sure it's on store shelves still. I'm not sure if it's made any. We'll flip there a little bit here, then I'll show you the end here. But yeah, this is really worth it. Yeah, when I buy an Eric Powell book, I always feel like I'm getting my money's worth of, you know, $3.99. But this is the Lords of Misery. I mean, that's an awesome name there. So, but yeah, I have to look and see if that came out, because I'm pretty much interested in reading it. But I like collecting the single issues, especially with Eric Powell's work. Like, I'm piecing together like the goon stuff, but I do have a trade paperback of that. I have with the Hillbilly. I bought that whole series. Then I just so happened to come across that he was, you know, doing this book. So highly recommended. But yeah, it's just a origin of this, or possible origin of this character from four different points of view, and the different you know, all the exaggerations and stories of how this person became what she is now. So throw this one back. I got one more I ordered through, I think, DCB. Yeah, this one I came. Of course, I have to get a Verotik comic whenever they come out. Now, I know I'm probably going to butcher this name, but I'm going to say it's Mortiana, maybe like that. Another Spanish book, so it must be on like a Mexican kick air or something like that. But yeah, this is everything you want in a Verotik comic. If you like, you know, people getting their organs ripped out and, you know, bones ripped out. You know, just violence and, you know, that kind of stuff. This is the book for you. I always pick them up when they come out new. There's really no, I looked to see if there's like a schedule of coming out for 2021, but I could not find anything. If anybody has any information, please let me know if there's a, where I can find this stuff. I looked at websites and stuff like that. I cannot find anything. I think, you know, this is Glenn Danzig's line with a, this is called Bisley Art 1 or 2, but, Danzig writes this, and I'm a huge Danzig fan, if you didn't know. I should have a new a record haul coming out here pretty soon too. So, but this is yeah, I always buy the books. Every time I go through back issues and stuff, I'm always looking for these books. So, but I have no idea what the schedule is. If there is even a schedule, he just, you know, writes one up. The guys that he hires to draw these books, and yeah, you know, they got the time, they all do it like that. So, but yeah, if anybody has any information, please put it down below so I can get it on my pull list or make sure I have everything ordered. So the next two are from the 50 cent bins. Like I said, I have so much stuff right now. I cannot be buying giant collections, or I'm running out of space. So I have to do like a sale here pretty soon. And I was talking about that in my previous video. Like, I got an Instagram channel or page and all that stuff set up. So, but with everything going on right now, I just got to hold off. But I went to it was a dollar boxes, but they're 50% off, so 50 cents. And I came out with two freaking books. And both of them I already own. So that tells you how much of an issue it is there. So I picked up this Mercy Sparks. It's a 99-cent special. It's the first appearance of that character. I actually met Josh Blaylock. He's a pretty cool dude. If you ever get a chance to meet him, definitely take that opportunity. But I bought a couple issues off of him, and I got him autographed or my autograph box. But yeah, I mean, I dig the character and the stories, but it's just one of them things. Like, I just picked it up because I really like this cover. Plus, mine had a bunch of ticks on it. And this one has a couple things. I mean, but it's a whole lot better than my book. So now I can actually get rid of the other one and keep a nicer copy. So, but I know all the spec channels and stuff like that. Every like other year or something, this book comes back up on it. But the last book is, surprisingly not a female lead, but it's the first appearance of one of my favorite characters, Mr. Monster. And sorry, if I see these for 50 cents, I'm not leaving it there to be destroyed. If I ever do a giveaway again, this is gonna be one of the books that goes in the collection, or the prize winnings. Yeah, it's the first appearance of Mr. Monster. I guess I can open it. I don't think I've ever shown it before. Yeah, I'll just show you right where the... There you go. So you can see what the inside looks like a little bit. But yeah, we have a con around here. Yeah, you can see it's beat up a little bit, but I don't care. We have a con around here called Three Rivers Con, and it got canceled last year, but I requested that Michael T. Gilbert be there, and then I guess they sent out the invite, and he accepted, and I was super happy. I had all these books. Yeah, I was going to pay the money. I'm not sure if he charges or anything like that. But I was going to get like at least three or four books signed, the top ones that I wanted signed, and I wanted to get a, you know, Mr. Monster sketch on something, you know. One of my blanks, like I think I got a couple Walking Dead, maybe I was going to think about that, I'm not sure, yeah, but something with Monster related. But of course, COVID hit, then everything got screwed up, and now here I am with no signed books and no sketch, but I still got the money put away, so if it all... I think they're going to try for May, or I can't remember if they moved it to October or so, but hopefully this year we get it done, and I'm going to make sure as soon as they start putting their posts on Facebook and stuff like that, I'm going to make sure, for damn sure, that I put that request in again. I'd also like to get Simon Bisley here, but we'll see. If I can get one, maybe the other one, they'll come a couple years ago, but I'm always... It's a really cool con, and they're really fan friendly, customer friendly, I guess it should be a better word, to try to get guests. I mean, I've requested some before, and they just, you know, were at other cons and stuff like that. I think they always try. If you put something up there, I mean, granted, you're not going to get like possibly like, you know, the bigger names like Todd McFarlane or Frank Miller or anything like that, but. I mean, who knows? I mean, they haven't been here for a while, so. Right through the, look at that, man. Damn. Some violent books. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Like I said, I should have a couple more videos coming out. I'm not sure exactly when they're going to be up. I think I'm going to spread them out a little bit, so if you found see for a week or two. But usually I do like three or four of these and I pop and I'm pieced out for 2 months. But hopefully, maybe I'll spread these ones out a little bit. All right, my friends, take care and stay safe. Talk to you next time.